Now that seating brackets are all filled, we go 32, 16, 8, 4, and we're gonna find out who is our 2024 Link Engine Management Pro Spec Champion.
A little bit of composure on his side, and Brudski does not get in the dirt, neither does Osoli. Transition now, was that a little early?
Oh, no!
Osoli, it was early!
Come on!
Osoli loses it, straightens out, and I saw it going down. You saw that transition. They're a camp that really is preparing cars properly, and Josh Love has shown you that car can be prepared well, but driving it, Josh Love, that was absolutely the bolts. Oh, look at Mata. He dives into the inside. Mata makes a big mistake. Oh, no, on that transition. Here goes Hansen. Oh, he gets in the dirt. Hansen gets in the dirt. Transitions out. He does save it. This is the second run, so even if he DB'd it, he would be able to side zone three. Who's going to the finals against Brudski?
Oh, no.
Mata goes off course.
All right, so we came into Utah. I knew it was the last opportunity for me to grab some kind of carbon fiber trophy, because this year it's been dry, it's been struggle. So in practice, we didn't do that well. I felt like we need to win and we're gonna do something, but practice did not sound like that, didn't show the results. So when we went into top 32, I just threw everything away, all the pressure and all the overthinking that I had. And I'm like, listen, I'm just gonna drive the way I drive, have fun and let my hands and feet do the job. And boom, just clicked, run after run after run. We had three sick battles with Connor. I ended up edging him out a little bit, cost him a championship. Sorry, dude, I know how much it means, but you know, we're not here just giving things out. You have to fight for it. So yeah, and after that gave me such a good boost, confidence and practice. So top 16 and on, it just clicking, clicking, clicking. Not easy battles, but I felt confident. I felt good. And all the way through, we are first place finish for the final round, which gave me so much confidence and so much motivation, because I was talking to my team. I'm like, what are we doing wrong? What do we need to do? And when I was like, we just need to win and everything's gonna fall back together. Sure enough, thank God it happened. We won and super motivated. We still have to finish a season in Irvindale for pro, get some more practice, get some more learning to do. And for next year, I'm leaning towards double duty again, but we'll see. We'll see what's gonna happen, how the partner's gonna come in, and what the whole situation's gonna be. But I'm super pumped that we still got it. We got the team together, even though we've been shorthanded most of the season. I did want to bring new people just to go through that learning curve, and just kept pushing with a few people that I had, my brother and Alex. So yeah, we are on a ninth flight right now and just happy. I don't know, super happy. I know, kind of forgot what it means to be up top, to get winning, you know, battle after battle, about to taste some champagne and just relax overall, because we needed that.
So we had an amazing weekend. We started very strong with a strong car. All we wanted is the championship, and we managed to achieve that in the top 32. So we were really, really happy. It removed a lot of weight on our shoulders. But in the top 8 against Katz and Nandis, we lost the supercharger belt, so we had to give up. But it was still an awesome race, and we still tried to do the full run just for the fans and for the show. So I think it was an awesome weekend. And for next year, we're really looking to go in pro. Hopefully we can do 8 rounds, or if we can, we're just gonna do the rounds that we are able to do with the budget. And I hope that you guys enjoy the show, because I really loved it, and thanks for all the support.